Praise the Lord, everyone. My name is Mari. I am an Apostolic Pentecostal. And if you're visiting my channel for the first time, welcome. If you don't know what we're all about accomplishing three main things. One, I wanted to create a space where apostolics can come and watch easily short, shareable messages with their friends and family so they can increase their faith. Two, I wanted to open up the eyes of current Christians to our beautiful, beautiful doctrine that we so greatly believe in. And three, ultimately, I just want to see the Word completely transform you and cleanse you from the inside out to become the image that God has in store for you. But because you have navigated your way to my channel, you have made it just in time for the Daily Mop. And in today's message of power, I'm going to be talking about His blood, your power. You right now have power. Now you may not know it. Actually, cut that. As a matter of fact, you don't have power. I'm not gonna give you that power. First and foremost, I can't give you that power. But what's this power you're talking about? Well, this power I'm talking about can only come from someone's blood. Now it's not your blood, it's not my blood, but it's the blood of Jesus. His blood has power over death. Did you know that? Do you realize when Jesus died, he rose again 3 days later? Why? Because his blood has so much power that death could not even handle it. And do you realize that you and I can have that same power? If we do what? If we choose to have his blood marked over us. Acts 2:38 gives the instructions of how we can receive his blood. And Peter said unto them, "Repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remissions of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost." See, I was very privileged this past weekend to attend an all-Spanish Apostolic Pentecostal convention. That talked about the power of the blood of Jesus. And I said, well, I know the blood has power, but how does it have power? What does it have power over? See, you and I are going to die. That's a fact. That's the first death. But that's not the death you really need to worry about, all right? That's just a continuation of life into an eternal heaven or to an eternal hell. But you really want to worry about the second death. Now, where is the second death mentioned in the Bible? Well, I'm glad you asked this. Revelations 2:11 tells us, "He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh shall not be hurt of the second death." Now, that's the first time we hear about the second death in the Bible, but nothing much is really explained of it until we get to Revelations 20, and we see the consequences of those who experience the second death. Revelations 20:13 through 15 says, "And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged every man according to their works, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire." This is the second death. "And whosoever was not written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire." I don't know about you, but in no way in any lifetime do I want to spend any time in a lake of fire. I think that was purposely written because you and I can relate to how hot fire is, and very clear what it says here, that if your name was not written into the book of life, you will be part of that second death that gets thrown into this lake of fire. So how do you get your name written into the book of life? Well, I told you in the very beginning of this video, Acts 2:38, you must be baptized in his name. See, the water represents the blood of Jesus. And we know that the blood has the power in it. And so when you mix these two together, when you go under in that water, it represents now that the blood now covers you, that your name is now written in the book of life, and you, with his blood, have the power to overcome death. Praise God. Can you just give God some love? I mean, when are you just going to get it together that you need to serve this God who has given you power over death? Hebrews 9:14 tells us, "How much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to serve the living God?" He does everything for us. He's giving us a free ticket. He's basically preventing us from experiencing this second death, which, as you read with your own two little eyes, how awful it will be if you will just get out of that chair, find an apostolic Pentecostal preacher, and say, "Hey, pastor, I want to be baptized in Jesus' name. I need this blood. I need this power, because I don't want to experience death." I don't think any of us do, but it is coming. And a select few will only experience one death, but those who don't get baptized in Jesus' name, my friend, you will experience a second death. So remember, it's his blood, but it's your power that you can control. Thank you all for watching. My name is Brother Mario. God bless you. Hey, I hope you all enjoyed that. Don't forget to like, subscribe, leave a comment down below. Definitely want to know what you all got out of it. But most importantly, share this message. Share it with your best friend. Put it on your Facebook. Slap it on your Instagram. Doesn't even matter. We're trying to get this message out. And hey, don't let your blessing streak in. Check out some of these other videos we got here. Hey, love you all so much. Gotta go. Bye-bye.